Chapter 62. Wait. The phoenix hath a bell for sound, fire for sight, a knife for touch, two cakes, one for taste, the other for smell. He standeth before the altar of the universe at sunset, when earth life fades. He summons the universe, and crowns it with magic light to replace the sun of natural light. Praise unto, and give homage to, raw hor kuit. To him he then sacrifices. The first cake burnt illustrates the prophet drawn from the scheme of incarnation. The second, mixed with his life's blood and evil, illustrates the use of the lower life to feed the higher life. He then takes the oath and becomes free, unconditioned. Burning up in the flame of his prayer, and born again, the phoenix. Chapter 63. Marjorie Daw. I love Layla. I lack Layla. Where is the mystic grace, sayest thou? Who told thee, man, that Layla is not new?
That has been fought, or one that will be, but any war, and the enemies who struggle here do not exist unless we call them into being. This forest then, and all that happens now, is outside history. Only the unchanging shapes of fear and doubt and death are from our world. These soldiers that you see keep our language and our time, but have no other country but the mind.
thank you for so many things tonight. First and foremost, I thank you for expanding my political vocabulary to include illustrative words such as moderator of fictional chaos, alternative fact maker, scam artist, involuntary comedian, reality TV actor, director, what's the name, the sexual apprentice, right-wing performance artist extraordinaire, the ultimate dystopian border artist, narcissista y psicótico, megalomaniaco, demagogue extraordinaire, heckler-in-chief, hate crimes promoter, master of conflict of interests, sexual assault perpetrator-in-chief, that orange thing, etc., etc. I hadn't used these words before in the realm of politics until you came along. Muchas gracias. You sound and behave like a neo-Nazi version of Louis Farrakhan, or a Las Vegas version of Mussolini.
Wonder you can't sleep at night. excerpt of the dead girl for whose death he considered himself responsible. He had totally blended his religious life and goals with his emotional life and goals. For him, Savior stood for lost friend. Horselover fat. Horselover fat told us that God had fired a beam of pink light at him. Horselover fat was actually in search of the dead girl glory, for whose death he considered himself responsible. He had totally blended his religious life and goals with his emotional life and goals. For him, Savior stood for lost friend. Horselover fat. Horselover fat told us that God had fired a beam of pink light at him. Horselover fat was actually in search of the dead girl glory, for whose death he considered himself responsible. He had totally blended his religious life and goals with his emotional life and goals. For him, Savior stood for lost friend.
Horselover fat.
Horselover fat told us that God had fired a beam of pink light at him. Horselover fat was actually in search of the dead girl glory, for whose death he considered himself responsible. He had totally blended his religious life and goals with his emotional life and goals. For him, Savior.
If I die, survive me with such sheer force that you awaken the furies of the palate and the cold. From south to south, lift your indelible eyes. From sun to sun, dream through your singing mouth. I don't want your laughter or your steps to waver. I don't want my heritage of joy to die. Don't call up my person. I am absent. Live in my absence as if in a house. Absence is a house so vast.
Thank you. está estrellada, y tira tanto azules los astros a lo lejos. El viento de la noche gira en el cielo y canta.
And I drink this wine solely to drown this misery of mine. Yet the last height of consolation's cold, its pinnacle is not to be consoled. And though I sleep with Jane and Eleanor, I feel no better than I did before. And Julian only fixes in my mind, even before feels better than behind. Your mercurial spirits be so kind as to enable me to raise the wine. Put me in Layla's arms again, the accursed, leaving me that else Hal may do his worst. Doni and Den, perceiving me inspired, conceived their task was finished, they retired. I turned upon my friend and, breaking bounds, borrowed a trifle of £200. Chapter 65. Sick Transient. At last I lifted up mine eyes and beheld. And lo, the flames of violet were become as tendrils of smoke, as mist at sunset upon the marshlands.
Thank you.